My name is Lorraine, and I'm from class of 2025.
My name is Mika Villacruzis, and I'm from the class of 2025.
There's a lot of things to do in Seattle. It's a great place to hang out with friends, and the people here are nature-loving.
I think Seattle is very beautiful. During our time at Octave 9, we went out to take photos of the city and Pike Place Market. Seattle is a place of food, a place of art, culture, and community, a place for nature and the animals we share the space with, and people, lots and lots of people. And there's still changes and improvement happening.
Seattle is a beautiful place, but there are areas of neglect, areas in which littering and garbage waste are often done. A way to demote this practice is using similar waste management used in Germany, using the deposit refund system in which consumers pay a deposit when purchasing bottles but paid back when returned. I want to bring attention to this waste management as this management showed effectiveness in citizens' recycling, which I believe our country should start following.
What are some of your concerns about the environment?
I would say some concerns regarding the environment would be global warming and climate change. They are contributing a lot to negative human health effects and impacting the environment negatively, such as ocean warming and ocean acidification and a lot of greenhouse gases. Like, it's all affecting humans negatively, and the people who are going to be most affected by this are minority groups.
What would you want to say to leaders or environmental policymakers?
I would say to fossil fuel industries to reduce their carbon emissions because it's increasing global temperatures and this is affecting everyone negatively. I would tell Congress and environmental policymakers to implement laws to protect nature and the future of the people.
What are some opinions you have on the environment that you would like to share?
I would say to be sustainable, be eco-friendly, and to reduce your carbon footprint, because the environment is very interconnected and we have to be responsible for our own actions and take care of planet Earth.
Really? I joined this simply for like an internship experience, and I needed an internship because to pass Big Picture, which is the school I go to, you have to have an internship by the end of the year or you don't get to pass, or it's one of the requirements to pass. Just like new things, new experiences, just getting to like be able to understand art better, I guess you could say. To be honest, I'm not sure. Words, none. I don't have a specific style yet. Maybe, I'm not sure. Probably not. Because I'm just not as interested in art as I used to be. Alright, humanity, it's kind of screwed at this point. Like, if you think about it, there are only, like, people do protests to get better or change the world, right? They do the protest, but what happens after the protest? They do nothing. Like, you can talk all you want, like.
We'll be starting off with the first question. What questions do you wish someone would ask you, or what opinions do you have about the environment?
One opinion that I have on the environment is that it's all very interconnected. So like land, sea, air, people, it's all interconnected. So when one starts to become, let's say, like polluted or something, it affects how the other ones react to that. And so if us humans, we pollute something, eventually that pollution is gonna end up hurting us in the process.
Moving on to the second question, what are your concerns regarding the environment?
My concerns regarding the environment is the way that some companies or like higher-ups kind of deal with it, because I feel like not everyone's opinions are getting heard, especially in countries who don't contribute a lot to climate change, but they still have, or but they're still affected a ton by the actions of like countries that are more developed.
Finally, the last question: what do you want to say to leaders and environmental policymakers?
I would say, please include everyone's voice, because many people can get discouraged or not included in a lot of conversations around climate change, and so it's important to integrate those communities, and because we're all human, so it would be in our interest to include all human voices.
Thank you.
As an individual can help better society when most people in power focus more on their own ideals. In a position of power where they can make decisions that can influence thousands of lives here in America. If politicians like these continue to stay in a position of power, we will stay as stagnant as we are today. But what we can do to improve and change the world is to vote for politicians who genuinely want a better society. If we can do that, not only will we see improvement in America, but the whole world will as well.
There's like any way humanity, especially scientists, can develop a more sustainable method that is more cheaper and accessible to everyone, so then we can care for the environment, which is being destroyed as we speak.
Yeah, I feel like definitely like people they've been trying to find a way to make sustainable options affordable, because in reality it's like that sustainability is only reserved for a certain population of people who can afford it. And if it's only a small group of people, what good is that doing to the earth if it's not the vast majority? Only real change can happen when a lot of people are working together to fix this.
Given the shift in generations, you think that the population on earth is starting to realize the I guess, consequences of their actions and of all the actions of humans in the past?
I feel like it's more prevalent, especially in younger people, because this is affecting us. It's affecting our future. So we're more, I guess, we have a bigger fear of it, because this is what we're gonna have to live into and grow up to be and live in, the environment that we'll have to get eventually used to. And while the older generation, they're not as worried because they already lived their lives. They already had children, they already like retired, they're on vacation basically. So it's not as urgent for them to solve the issue here. You can see that a lot in just the way how politicians act, how even our parents are. I don't think there'll be an absolute fix. It'll take time and effort, and it's something that it's a collective thing that we as humans, it's a duty we have to protect this earth and to also protect each other. And I feel like now is very much the time where we need to realize that and get over our differences and start working with each other.
I would like to ask those in power is, what are the true goals of a politician in today's society? One would hopefully assume that it's to improve the world and use their power in their area to help push with the world forward and make it a better place. Unfortunately, oftentimes through the media, through news, through anywhere we see politicians in action, this is not the case. So often do we see politicians going back and forth with each other, just trying to shape their area of power to fit their own ideals.
It could be different political parties, this treatment or mistreatment of minorities, and so many other things that are almost inconsequential to things that we should actually be focusing on. Things like poverty, global warming, pollution, and so many other things that are leading to the slow self-destruction of our Earth is all overshadowed by things that are almost so small in comparison. But with as our society stands, and how people seem to always emphasize looking at smaller changes instead of focusing on improving the world while it's slowly dying, what can we really do?
So what's your name?
Rin.
What grade are you in?
I'm a senior in Franklin High School.
What do you think about the homelessness in Seattle?
Oh, the homelessness? I mean, we see it by Franklin. There's a whole little area where some people who don't have a home reside in, and I sometimes wish that people took action more so they have a more safer space, because that area is a bit dangerous because of all the cars going back and forth, you know. And I mean, going downtown too, you see people just laying on the side, and I feel like the city could do a better job at that.
Yeah, and what do you think contributes to how someone can go onto the streets?
I definitely like the prices for housing going up, for sure, because it's difficult to live here. Just having an apartment is expensive, unfortunately, and it shouldn't be that way. Food, I mean, there's also the inflation with other stuff, recently specifically, but there's also just a lot of different aspects and all the taxes you have to pay too, which just adds layers on top of layers of money being taken away. And there's also people losing their jobs specifically because of the coronavirus, and that leaves people on the streets.
And you said you were gonna be a college student, so how do you think that's gonna affect your financial security?
Oh, wow, I'm actually looking for a job right now so I can have some pocket cash, because my parents can't afford everything because of the tuition price is very expensive. My parents are on a few loans because of my dad's car being totaled. We have medical bills that means my dad got sick, or he used to be very ill. He had cancer, so there's a bunch of medical bills we have to still pay back and other stuff. So it's just all of that piled on top of each other with private college, which just adds more. So I'm just trying to find a part-time job probably during the summer and when I'm in school, so I can sustain money for myself and have pocket cash for miscellaneous things and food, so my parents don't have to care for that too much.
And why do you think that, because there's so many people who are like you who have bills piling on top of each other, and why do you think it's so hard for someone just to live in America? Just to be able to survive?
I think it's just because of all the money problems, you know, with people obsessing over money and getting more rich. The rich are becoming richer. I mean, it's not that like they don't donate at all to charitable, but charitable kind of organizations. But I feel like they should share more of the money, because all the big businesses, they just have a bunch of money there, and there's like smaller businesses not getting a lot of money. It's hard to keep up a business if you're a small business. There's not enough, I guess, jobs too, because education is important in this country. And a lot of people are just like, well, if you can't go to college, you can't get a job. And so then there's just a lot of people without jobs, a lot of people not being able to afford things, and then just people trying to get more money.
I'm also dreaming with silver and gold, missing from a movie. That every broken heart knows. You walk in the moonlight and you pull me close. The second you disappear, I will.
Like a lot of stuff that can, like the plates and everything, they're compostable. A lot of kids put them in the trash though, unfortunately. There's not a lot of compost bins anywhere, and it's just like things that are compostable. It should be accessible. There's only one in the lunchroom, I think. And then they perform outside, and then performances are canceled because of like it's raining or anything. If like the climate gets worse here, I mean, San Jose is already raining. But like, if it gets worse, then it'll be harder for me to walk outside because the climate worsens, then probably more rain or something. That would ruin those opportunities. Yeah, I do like small things. Like, I've always been taught to turn off the light when you're not using it so you save energy, and like just turn off the water and be careful with the faucets, and you save like plastic bags you get from the store and have a whole drawer of them. So we use it if we need to recycle and use it again. Or plastic water bottles, we reuse them. Like, you know, we don't use plastic water bottles as much because we have like metal water bottles. But we also keep those water bottles that we bought from the store so we can use them again, so we don't have to throw them away. A lot of recycling habits. Thankful to my parents for that. I don't know, like the place. Our school is like very diverse, right? I went to a private school before, and there it was just Japanese kids or people who were like half Japanese or like that environment. I was the only queer kid. And then I was like the butt of the joint came to creation, so I guess that was a place where I was underrepresented. Like public school, I feel like there's a very diverse community. Yeah. The teachers should be more diverse though. There's a lot of white teachers instead of other races, or there's not a lot of queer teachers either. So I feel like that could be pretty good.
What is your name and age?
My name is Mariela Cordero and I am 17 years old.
In Sioux, I am 17.
My name is Hannah Chang. I am
17. What is your occupation?
I am a senior at Franklin High School.
I am a student at Franklin High School.
I'm a student and I'm currently unemployed.
Okay. Do you think you do your part in protecting the environment?
I would say a little bit.
I think I could definitely be doing better.
No, I do not.
I use transportation, such as taking the train, taking the bus.
Better. I try to be conscious about a lot of the decisions I make, especially around like how often I drive or how long I drive.
I don't think I'm knowledge enough in protecting the environment, like the process of recycling and such things.
Do you think big corporations do their part in protecting the environment?
No.
For the most part, I would say no.
No, they do not.
And why is that?
If you look at corporate policy and look at their procedures, companies as a whole to make profit, to exploit whatever they can or not.
These corporations have the most power in terms of being able to help fight the climate crisis and protecting the environment, but a lot of them fall short, whether it's by greed or just because that's how the system is set up.
Corporations such as fossil fuel industries are emitting fossil fuels into the atmosphere. This is causing a lot of negative human health effects, such as asthma, and I believe that corporations should take action.
And what is one thing you think everyone can do to help protect the environment?
I would say being more sustainable, being more eco-friendly.
One thing that I think everyone can do is to simply learn about your environment, or not even just your environment, like the environment overall, because when you learn about it, you can see that the environment is very interconnected. Land, sea, and air, everything flows together. So if one gets polluted, then it affects the other aspects of that.
Thank you.
My final question would be, what do you think of Adam?
I think Adam is a great teacher, but I think he would be even cooler if we got to run around here, and if we got to go on the stage.
Okay, that's it.
That's going to be. Thank you.